For more updates, click on subscribe and click on bell button for latest notifications. Hi friends, welcome to Tech ArkIT YouTube channel. My name is Ravi. In this video session, we are going to see that how to install and configure FTP server.
Like, share, comment, and subscribe.
So, what does mean by the FTP server? FTP, in a sense, file transfer protocol. Which, using this FTP server, you can transfer the protocol. Like, there is no dependency on the platforms, like where you use a Windows server, or where you may use Linux server, where you may use Mac OS or different platforms, but still you can access this FTP protocol from any of the platforms, and you can transfer the files from one platform to other platform. It's going to be very, very useful for you to transfer the protocols, files, or the directories, or zipping up. So maybe if you have a bulk files, example, say that a huge size in file, if you wanted to send to the remote client where the user cannot have access to your network, but still you wanted to send some files, using this FTP you can send the files to the clients where upload the files and share the FTP link so that they can log in and download the files, or they can also upload the files and you can download the files from your end. By default, the VS FTPD is the service name. So in this, you have to start and install the packages, and 20 and 21 is the port numbers of the FTP. For one is for using the upload and one is for download, and the default configuration path is going to be a /etc/vsftpd.config. Okay, and the document root, by default the root path is going to be a /var/pub/ftp is the default FTP path, where you can store some files and upload files which can be downloaded over the browser, or maybe you can also use some clients. Example, say that FileZilla clients, or maybe a Winner CPR, anything, you can connect to FTP and download and upload the files, managing your files for the FTP as a local browsers. You can also use the browser to connect it. So I'm just going to use this m install vsftpd star. The dependency package is also going to be installed over here, and vsftpd package has been installed. Now systemctl, and say that enable vsftpd, so it's going to be enabled whenever the service has been restarted, and say the service has been start, and check it up the status. The status is now it's working fine, right? Now firewall -cmd -permanent -add service equal to FTP, or you can also use port number 20 and 21, something like this. Okay, or else like add port equal to 20/TCP or 21/TCP, something like this also you can use. And now reload this settings so that the firewall change is getting affected. After that, what you can do, you can just go to the client side and install the FTP configuration FTP and browse the file system. So maybe you can simply go to /var/ftp and pub is the location where I can put some files. Touch, example, say that FTP test, I say that 1 to 20 or 1 to 10.txt files you just created, and 10 files has been created over here. Now you can simply go to this web and browser, I'm just using this browser over here and say that FTP /192.168.2.51. Now you can see this, the pub location, and these are the files. You can see this. Okay, now this is just like you can one side you can upload it and client can download it, or maybe you can also use FTP commands where you can simply connect using this FTP. Okay, FTP, and say that 192.168.2.51, and say that the username is FTP by default and the password is also FTP by default. Now I can say that login has been successful. Conm install FTP over here. Now FTP 192.168.2.51, and now username is FTP and FTP is the password. Login is successful. Now you can simply type ls and you can see the directory over there, and go to pub and type ls. You can see this, all the please follow us on social networking sites. If you have any technical related questions, you can ask.